We talked about the two different types of relationships, the one-to-many and many-to-one. Here I want to go over the many-to-many, which, by the way, Access does not support many-to-many relationships. In other words, it doesn't support multiple records in one table corresponding to multiple records in another. For this example, I've got these two tables here, like the employees, or I've got the employee ID duplicated. Why? Because you got the same employee working on different projects. Where in the projects table, I've got the project ID duplicated because I can have different employees working on the same project. So you see the problem that I'm running into here, that when I want to relate these two tables together, they would create a many-to-many relationship, so that's not going to work because there's no unique field. But to get around that, well, let me show you. Let's come up here, go to the Database Tools tab, to the Relationships, click on Relationships, and I like visuals here. So you've got these two tables. What I can do to bring them together is to create an intermediary or join table, wherein I will take the employee ID and put it in that table, and then the project ID and put it in the join table as well. Sure, I'll have duplicate employee IDs in that table and duplicate project IDs, but collectively, I won't have the same employee ID and project ID for one record listed in the next record. Well, let me show you. Let's go ahead and create, close out of here, our join table. Come up here, click on the Create tab, go to the Tables group. Let's do it by design. So the first field we'll pull from the Employees table. This will be ID, hit the Tab key. And we want to make sure it's got the same data type, so let's go to the Employees table, right-click on it, go to the Design view, Employee ID, short text, great. And then the field size is 4, so let's come back to our table here. Short text and the field size, we want to keep it the same, and then hit Enter. And then for the project here, the ID, we could say it's project ID or number. Just remember that if you name it differently, it's just up to you to make sure it's got the same data type and type of data within that field, and that you remember what that field's about. That's why I like to name them the same, so I can relate the project ID to the project ID here. Well, in any case, let's hit the Tab key. It's short text is the project ID in here. Right-click, go to the Design view. Also short text, yes. And the field size is 6, so let's come back here, come down here and change that field size to 6 as well and hit Enter. And like I said, we're going to have duplicates when we add records from the employees table, because in the employees table it includes the employee ID and the project ID. So come back here, well, right click, go to the datasheet view, see the employee ID and the project ID. Well, it's not include some of these here because there's no project that these employees are working on, and that's okay. When we do an append query, as you recall in an earlier training video, we can take records from one table and add them to another, and that's what I want to do here. And when it can't find something here, it just doesn't bring it over. It doesn't prevent it from being added, any record within the table here, just those that don't have a complete record. Like we got 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so back here, like I said, we can have duplicates here, but not collectively. And do you recall in an earlier training video that when you assign a primary key to one, let me come up here, click on the Design tab, you come over here and click on it. But when you assign a primary key to two or more, it becomes a composite key. So that means that instead of having this, allowing no duplicates, which is impossible because it's going to have duplicates, and that one's going to have duplicates, but collectively, we come up here and assign both of them the primary key. We can't have an employee ID working on one project number listed again, the entire record as a duplicate. Individually, yes, but not collectively. So let's come up here and click on the Save button and TBL. We'll call this our Assignments table. Hit Enter. Click the View button. No records here. And we want to create. Come up here, click on the Create tab. Go to the Queries group. We'll do Query by Design. An append query that will take the records from the Employees table and add it to the Assignments table. Because in the Employees table, double click, close out. It's got both the employee ID from that table and the project ID that we want from, well, it's the foreign key field in the employees table, but would be the primary key in the projects table, but we can't have that, hence the join table. So we can actually have between these two fields a uniqueness that can't be found in these fields separately. So let's go ahead and double click to add the employee ID, double click to add the project ID, and let's come up here on the Design tab, go to the Query Type group, and let's do Append. And it says, okay, where's the table? Click on the drop-down arrow. It's the Assignments. Go ahead and click Okie Dokie. Then down below it says it'll add the records from the field here to that field in the assignments table. Now why is it not doing it for the project ID to the project field in the assignments table? Well, there's another good reason why I want to keep the names the same, because Access can quickly see that, hey, these are the same. This field has the same name in this table as this field in the other. And since these fields don't have the same name, project ID, I have to go down and identify it myself, and it's project number. So again, I did this to prove a point. And then let's go ahead and come up here, click on the Fun Run button. And it says you're about to append 25 rows. And remember, of the 25, there's 4 that won't come over because they're blank. Click Yes. And it says it can't do it because of violations, because remember, primary keys don't allow duplicates or empty values. So let's go ahead and see. Yes, we'll continue. And that should be it. We can close out of the query. I don't need it anymore once I've done it. And then, hey, where's the records? Well, since the table's been opened, we have to come up here and refresh. There we go. Cool. So we got duplicates over here, but between the two, we shouldn't have one record with the employee ID 12 and the project number 800 duplicated again. We can have 12 and 900, we just can't have 12 and 800. We could also have 813, but just, again, not the same employee on the same project duplicated. Same employee on different projects, or different projects for the same employee, we're good. Okay, on to the next training video, where we need to restructure the two tables before we can connect or relate to the junction table, these two tables. Because in the two tables, we now need to make the ID fields as primary key fields. But that's not going to work because currently there are duplicate data in those fields. And the reason we can now make those fields in the two tables into primary key fields is because it'll be duplicated over here in the junction table, the assignments, where it's going to allow duplicates individually but not collectively by record. And so that's how we're basically going to restructure it, is by assigning the primary key to the employee ID in the employee table and the primary key to the project ID in the project table. But again, we have to eliminate the duplicates prior to assigning the primary keys to the two tables and then allowing us to link them up to or relate to the primary key fields in the junction table. Thanks for watching. Hey, as a quick reminder, if you like my video, please give it a thumbs up. You can also click on me and subscribe to my channel to get notified of the latest videos. And for great specials on my products, please see the description below this video.